Get ready, start. Sir, the president's address has been discussed in this August house for 3 full days. I understand that 37 speeches have already been delivered. The debate has touched upon various aspects of the problems affecting our country. I have followed it with close interest and care. The president's address gives a picture of the country as a whole. It is intended to place before the House the full program for the future, the methods that we propose to adopt, the program for progress that has been chalked out, and the achievements that have so far been recorded. A picture like that has to be viewed from a correct angle. It is necessary that a sense of perspective and proportion should be maintained. If one does not try to take a balanced view of things or looks at the picture from an acute angle, then the judgment must be distorted. One should not allow his vision to be obstructed by individual happenings. The House has taken a favorable view of the address and it has commended itself to the approval and support of the good sense and wisdom of the House. I am grateful to the honorable members for their support in general to the basic policies which have been set forth in this address. During the last 6 or 7 years, there has been steadily a shift in the subjects that are dealt with in the address. The economic and the developmental issues have been coming more and more to the front. It is but proper that it should be so. An underdeveloped country has to give first place to the problems, solution of which will result in the satisfaction of hunger and the fulfillment of the needs of those who are suffering from lack of essential commodities needed even for bare sustenance. So the economic issues have naturally formed the most part of this debate, and various views about vital matters have been expressed, but basically all seem to be agreed. We want to establish a new rich socio-economic order, an order in which there will be a substantial share of the good things of life for everyone, and in which all will be bound by the bonds of goodwill. So that is an objective which must necessarily appeal to every member of this House. Success will depend on increasing our production in all fields. We have to see that the advance towards social justice is not in any way hampered. For mere increase in production, unless it is accompanied by social justice, cannot result in equitable distribution. Even for providing adequate incentives, it is necessary that there should be a feeling in every man and woman in the country that there are better days in store for him or her. So as we take these steps, we would have the active support of all who are in a position to work for the enrichment of the community. So it calls not only for production but also for such measures as will ensure the welfare and goodwill of those who are in the backwaters today. Even for the proper use of production, it is necessary that there should be a measure of advance among the mass of the people. Otherwise, the goods produced will not be consumed and there will be no purchasers for them, and so production will shrink. It has been so in certain cases. When production is to be coupled with social justice and we have big schemes and very ambitious projects to bring this about, there may be occasional jerks and jolts. We must not on that account get depressed. Institutional changes have to be made and other social steps have to be taken. So we should not get perplexed or confused by such contingencies. In our own world, March, there may be occasions when we may feel that everything is not smooth and that there are hurdles on the way. There are bound to be such hurdles. We have to go forward with faith, determination, and courage, and unless we make up our mind to follow resolutely the course that we have laid down, we shall not be able to achieve what we all desire. I hope there is no difference of opinion about the goal. Our goal is the achievement of a socialist democratic society. The country's goal, as it is even now laid down, is a socialist cooperative commonwealth. While working for economic advancement, we have to preserve the human values for which we have always stood. We have to see that the fundamentals of democracy are not impaired. Progress can perhaps be accelerated and we can perhaps march forward even more quickly if we resort to coercive methods, have little regard for those fundamental values which, after all, matter more than everything material. Full stop.